Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I greet you in the new year, and this is a new episode of the Women's World, during which we discuss all what concerns the Egyptian women. My name is Amal Mukhtar. A short break, and I'm going to be back with you. Welcome back. Well, in this episode, we are going to discuss how to lose weight during the feast and during the winter time. And to shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to have this phone with our dear guest, Dr. Nahla Bekri, a nutrition expert. Good day for you.
Hello.
Hello. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you too, all our guests.
Yes, thank you very much. Well, Dr. Bekri, now because of the new year and the Christmas, there are, of course, family gatherings and invitations and a lot of food, a lot of sweets. So tell us about ideas that we could control this or control our weight.
Yeah, Egypt is always going from one feast to the other, and we are very festive around food. Egyptian
yes.
families.
Yes.
So it's very important to live a normal life, to enjoy our festivities without going overboard with our calories.
Yes.
So the best way to do this, if we have planned like a party plan for any time during the day, that we eat regular meals, but smaller, very small snacks, and save our calories to this meal. For instance,
yes.
if we are invited for dinner, and we expect to eat food around 8 or 9 p.m. So we plan our day going backwards. So if we're going to eat around 9, so we eat a small snack around 6, another snack at 3, another snack at 12, another snack at 9 a.m. You see what I mean? So every
yes.
3 hours, we can eat very, very small snacks like
yes.
fruit and yogurt, some nuts and the fruit, something like this.
And concerning the invitation or the family gathering that we are going to have dinner at 9 p.m. So we take small of everything, one spoon from every dish, you mean?
No, no. I'm talking about, first of all, I'm talking about how to plan your day.
Yes, I know about the day, yes. Yeah. But what about the meal? Yes, the meal itself.
We take one dish and we divide it into half. Mm. One half of the dish, you put vegetables, whether cooked or raw, like a salad or anything, or cooked in half of the dish. The other half, we choose what we like. Because in Egypt, you know, our meals, there are like a lot of dishes. You're not going to eat from everything, but you choose the, you know, what you like, and you put it in half, a little of everything in half of your dish. And eat only one dish, only one plate.
Yes.
Don't go for a second plate and a third plate and eat it slowly and stay away from where the food is displayed so you don't get, you know, the craving. And then when you have a dessert later on, you also do the same thing, but in a smaller plate, like a very small plate. You take what you like, a few bites from what you like, and that's it.
Yes. Dividing the plate, this is a very good idea and very simple way of thinking and of losing weight. We are going to divide it to half or a quarter. It's a very good idea, of course, for everyone. So my second question is, Dr. Bekri, concerning the winter time, it's much more harder to lose weight because we are not moving a lot like in the summer. In the summer, we're traveling, we're going to the club, we're playing sports, we're going to the swimming pool. But in the winter time, we're not moving that much. So what's your advice concerning losing weight during the winter?
In the winter, you can use soups, which is like a liquid diet.
Yes.
So you can make like vegetable soups, like zucchini soup, a tomato soup, pumpkin soup, okay? And drink a lot of soup. And then when you come to eat your meal, eat small bites.
Yes.
So make most of your calories or most of your food coming from liquids. Hot liquid, and then also hot cocoa, cacao, but pure cacao. It's really good for you. It makes you, keeps you warm, and it's very low in calories, okay? And you will feel full. That's the whole idea, that you want to feel full.
Yes. So what are the good exercises and sports that we could exercise during the winter time to lose weight?
The best thing is walking, of course. Mm.
Yes.
You can walk and it will warm you up, or any kind of exercise you like. I swim. I even swim in the winter.
Yes.
And I ride a bike also, riding bikes, if you can do that. It's dancing, aerobics classes, or going to the gym. Going to the gym is very good for you, or even if you have a house gym, like if you have dumbbells or the exercise elastic band, and you can follow an exercise video right in the comfort of your own home. And exercise, and the most important thing, since we're mentioning exercise, is to know how many hours do we need to exercise per week.
Yes.
As adults, we need to exercise 4.5 hours per week.
Yes.
And children need to double that.
Yes.
Okay? So in order to fit in 4 hours a week, we need to at least exercise 1/2 hour a day or 1 hour every other day.
Yes. Yes. So, Dr. Bekri, concerning people with chronic disease like the diabetes, and what's your advice for them?
For diabetics, the most important thing is regular meals. They cannot skip meals. They have to eat every 3 to 4 hours, a balanced meal. Also dividing their plate in half. Half of the plate should be vegetables, and the other half should be protein. Carbohydrates should come in the whole form, like the beans or ferik, you know, or barley or bulgur, whole grains or quinoa. They should not eat simple carbohydrates. They should not eat pasta or rice or white bread. They should avoid that. Instead, they should replace with whole grains.
Yes.
And if they always use the divide the plate method, they can be balanced. And some of my diabetic patients, they like to eat sweets also. So I tell them, if you want to eat a bite or two of sweets, make sure that you put next to it fat or protein. Like, for instance, yes. I'll give you an example. If you are dying to eat a piece of basmousa, for instance, and you're a diabetic, make sure that you add cream, ishta, on it. So that will stabilize the sugar spike.
Yes.
And also nuts, which are protein. Okay?
Yes.
Instead of just saying, oh, it's okay, nothing will happen, just one time. And you know how it is in Egypt. Every day we have some kind of party or festivity. So we need to have a plan. Right?
Yes.
So the plan is that whenever you want to eat something sweet or something that is high in sugar, you need to also apply the breaks, put the breaks, which is the fat and the protein next to it.
Yes. Also, Dr. Bakri, concerning increasing immunity during the winter time, and especially with the threats of having a cold or flu or COVID. So what are the kind of food that we should take, and the vitamins and the useful food that we should take?
The most important thing to boost our immunity is that we have to drink lots of fluids. We want to make sure that we are hydrated. So, and then we also make this precaution that we gargle with salt and water, and we do this nasal wash with salt and water every single day. So just in case the bacteria comes in, it just kills it right away. I also like to add the honey with the lemon mix. It's also very good to boost your immunity. And you make sure that you're eating a balanced diet. A balanced diet, that means half of the plate is fruits and vegetables. The reason, because the vitamins and minerals that boost your immunity are several. And you're not going to have them in one meal. But if you do a variety of meals, then you make sure that your intake, you know, it's enough for all these vitamins and minerals. And these vitamins and minerals are vitamin A, vitamin B6, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, folate, iron, selenium, and zinc. See, there are several immunity-boosting vitamins and minerals. And so when you ensure that during the day you're eating five colors of fruits and vegetables, that's going to be like the multivitamin pills.
Yes.
And these five colors are the orange, the white, the red, the purple, the green. Between the fruits and vegetables, you make sure you eat that. Of course, you need to also ensure that you eat enough healthy fats like olive oil that has vitamin E, like the green leafy and the broccoli that has the folate, and of course the meat that has the iron and the spinach, and so on and so forth.
Yes.
So it's a variety, you know, you have to make everything into variety of proteins, variety of grains, variety of fruits and vegetables, making sure to boost your immunity.
Yes. Dr. Bakri, what's your opinion concerning the food with the red sauce, especially the young kids like very much the red sauce in all the meals, especially macaroni. So what's your opinion about the red sauce?
Red sauce meaning tomato sauce?
Yes.
Tomatoes are very, very healthy. Actually, the fresh tomatoes, they contain a lot of vitamins and minerals, and the main mineral, lycopene. So lycopene is this nutrient that is helping the heart and the cells.
Yes.
So tomato sauce is very healthy when it's made from fresh ingredients or even tomato paste. So yeah, it's good if they like to eat whether the vegetables or the red tomato sauce or the pasta. That's okay.
Yes. Dr. Bakri, what are the kinds of food that we should completely avoid? It's not healthy, it's not useful, causes obesity. Yeah. Tell us about this.
We should avoid processed foods and sugar-laden foods, like the sodas, diet sodas, whether they're diet or real, should avoid completely. And they are full of colors, and these colors, they cause stomach cancer, okay? Mm. And then you should also avoid all the processed meats, like luncheon meats and sausages and all the processed. But the baladi sausage, that's fine, because it's made from real meat, you know what I mean, and spices.
Yes.
And You should avoid cereals, processed cereals, all the flakes and the corn flakes and all these things that kids eat every day. They're just full of sugar and preservatives. And these should be avoided. You should eat the real food, like belila, for instance, made from whole wheat, whole grains. You should eat farik instead of white rice. You should eat the you know, beans, nuts. These are real food, meat, fruit, vegetables, okay? You should eat the real food, honey, cream, asal,
honey,
like molasses, and tahina.
Molasses, yes.
These are real. Eat that instead of the processed food.
Yes. Dr. Bakri, the young kids are going crazy with the sweets, with the chocolates. We cannot stop them. So what's your advice for the mother?
Well, you know, when you educate the kids, you open the computer and you start searching the benefits of the good foods and all the harmful foods and what they do for you. And you look at you know, the videos show all these harmful foods, what they do to your body, the kids would start to avoid them. But if you just tell them, oh, you cannot have that, without explaining to the kid, of course, it's not going to accept that. The other thing is that you make your kid prepare his own or her own food. Like, invite the kids to the kitchen and let them prepare the food, learn about food, learn about how they are prepared, how we wash, how we clean, how they will take ownership and they're going to like eating healthy and eating the real food.
Yes, yes. So, Dr. Bakri, some teenagers, boys or girls, are overweight and the mother is very afraid. She doesn't want them to be overweight, and at the same time she wants them to eat useful food. So how can we deal with this or advise the teenagers to take a small amount of food, yet useful one?
Well, the first thing that I would advise the mothers is to lead by example, because also, again, with my patients, I see a mother who is overweight and eating all the wrong foods with her husband and then telling her teenager, girl or boy, you cannot have that. So you have to lead by example. If you want your kids to eat healthy, first you have to be the healthy example, right?
Yes.
That's the most important thing. So the whole household has to start adopting some healthy things. First of all, stop bringing all these diet drinks and all the sodas in the house,
yes.
All these fizzy drinks. Stop getting delivery instead of cooking real food. Yeah, there are other delivery, other plans that are, you know, really healthy. But, you know, don't go for the cheaper chains that are so, so bad for your kids. So when you get this food and the kid will smell it and then you tell them, but you can't eat that, that's not fair.
Yes.
So this is the whole transformation that I'm inviting all the mothers to start adopting. A healthy lifestyle for the whole family, not just for that girl. Mm. Okay?
Yes.
And then also, as a family, we go for a walk together, we stop watching TV, and we play a board game together. It's a whole system that we have to adopt.
Yes.
If we want our teenager, which is the most tough age to handle, you know?
Yes.
But I had kids, and I know that this is what I did. I had to lead by example. I had to make it into a family affair so my kids would find this as fun, not as a punishment.
Yes. I thank you very much for your time. Thank you for your valuable information. Happy New Year to you and your family. Thank you very much, Dr. Nahla Bakri, a nutrition expert. Thank you very much for joining us over the phone. Ladies and gentlemen, a short break and I'm going to be back with you. Well, with this, my dear viewers, we come to the end of this episode of Opera Women's World. My name is Amal Mukhtar. Thank you for watching.